going now.
Just Jesus and the Holy Spirit.
I had a...
You know what I'm saying? That's what they teach you. Well, no, it's a Heavenly Father and it's a Son. That first Son, the first seed of the Heavenly Father is the word entered into Jesus. So, like I said, if you're going to pray, like you're walking down, depressed, you know, in mourning, like we all doing, in mourning, call on His name, praying in your mind. That name, Yahweh Shah. Pray, it comforts you. And read your Bible. Isn't the scriptures the comforter?
Yeah.
This is the comforter. Where's your Bible at? You see? Got to read that Bible. That's the comfort, you know? We're Israelites and we're naturally we're compassionate people. We don't want to see people suffering. But if you're wicked, we're going to put curses on you. You know? We're going to put curses on you. But normally, we don't want people suffering. Well, that's all that when all the people are, when we're on top again, man, that's gonna be the king. But get used to it while you're here. The suffering, the mourning, the depression. Get used to it while you're here. You know? You're a woman, though. You can't see it as, yeah, but that's the only advice I can give you. Read your Bible. You call on that right hand. That's all I can do. Right. That's what you do. Praying is pretty much mourning. In most people's eyes, in some people's eyes, to the wicked, praying is praying for, man, I need $1 million. I need that rod.
Praying for that new house.
Yeah, you know.
The new job.
I need, there's a difference. The wicked pray their way and the righteous pray their way, you know. Look, like I said, you know, pray to the Heavenly Father. I can't remember now. What was it? Timothy 2 and 10, I think. I think that was it. I can't remember now. Man. I mean,
second. What was you talking about?
I mentioned something about the name.
Come on, pray without ceasing?
No. Yeah, it's perfect, man. It's just a spirit. Go there. Well, it's only 10. Book of Numbers, I'm sorry.
2 Timothy 2 and 9. Wherefore I suffer trouble as an evildoer. Even unto bonds.
He suffered as an evildoer. Oh, ain't none of us righteous. All of us are evildoers. You understand what I'm saying? So I'm leading you back to that track. The fear of the Lord, that's the beginning of you being on that path of knowledge. The fear, you learn the fear. You feel this fear right now by you, whatever you're going through. I don't know what you're going through, but that's part of that fear. He's putting you through this. The Lord's putting you through this. Go ahead, bro.
But the word of God is not bound. Therefore, I endure all things for the elect's sake.
Didn't say endure. Didn't say go do suicide, jump in front of one of these vehicles. Endure. You know, endure. Put up with it.
Yep. You know?
That they may also attain the salvation which is in Christ Yahweh Shai with eternal glory.
That's right. But we only going through this because we were fools back in the day in our previous lives. You know about reincarnation? Reincarnation. It's all through the scriptures. All of us lived many lives. And we committed sins in our previous lives.
You wanna do it?
So we're paying for some of it now.
I don't mind doing it, but you can do
in
it.
In this life. Go ahead. You heard that we in the last days now.
If you still read
now,
stuff, you can finish it.
We in the last days now.
Got one.
You look at the
Mike, can you change the subject?
Oh, here.
Search the population of the world and do a
I don't never get to do the camera, so I don't mind. Now,
you'll see that the more and more souls are coming back on earth as time gets closer and closer to the time when the Lord comes. There's over 7 billion, probably 8 billion people on earth now.
How many did you get?
That's called Day of Judgment here. Those people, it's time that everybody faces judgment. Now that's where all this world, all this madness is headed to. Judgment time is coming. And judgment time, and I don't care who you are, what you got, how much money you got, judgment time is not going to be pretty. It's going to be some ugly times here. You see it happening now. You see all these niggas killing each other, shooting each other. Cops going after our people, you know? That's because we're getting to the end now. We're getting close to the end now. We gotta endure this shit. But you a woman, like I said, I can't say what we, I can't even judge. Man, you know, you women just, you know.
They gotta give it a lot.
Right. Yeah, it's gonna be hard. You think these men, the scriptures say these men is going to be crying like a woman. Now, if a man is going to be crying like a woman, what do you think a woman is going to be doing?
Exactly.
You know?
And what happened to our women have been polluted in this country? Because America is essentially the kingdom of Satan, all right?
Yep.
They got a satanic demonic vibration out here on our people. That's why our women, they have no respect for themselves. They have no respect for the Lord. They walk around half naked. They're on drugs. They're prostitutes. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying?
This is crazy.
They have no idea what the word marriage means until death do us part. They say that.
Right, yep.
But there's no kind of loyalty. The men are just as bad. But there's no loyalty. There's no sense of morality out here. There's no morality. None.
And before each nation falls, and I mean before each nation in ancient times, before that nation was destroyed, like ancient Rome, ancient Egypt, the morals of that nation were down the gutter.
Right.
They didn't have no morals.
Just like America, they just legalized gay marriage. Now a man can marry a man and a woman can marry a woman. That's backwards as hell.
Do you know what the scripture says to do to a lesbian or a homosexual? It says to kill them. Now, I ain't me making that up. That's just in the scriptures. You know? Yeah, we put here to judge. When they tell you that nobody can judge me but God. Well, we gods and we can judge. And that's why we're out here. We're judging. You know? Before the Lord destroyed those nations, he sent his prophets out to tell that nation why they're being judged and that they're going to be destroyed. But let me get this for you.
That's that good water, man.
Yeah.
Every time I drink good water, I feel like I get a buzz.
How about that living water?
Boy, that too.
That living water.
I definitely get a buzz off of this. Because really, this is what this is. Right now, it was like we're living in a desert, right? There's no plants, it's all concrete. So we're living in the desert out here. Everybody's thirsty, dying of thirst, and this right here is an oasis.
That's right. Didn't I tell you go home and get your Bible? Get you one and keep it reading. Don't just keep it carrying around like the hypocrites do.
Read
the book. Read it. You know?
Pray before you
get
read.
Get with your girlfriends, some girls you know, read it. Read it. And that's what the problem is. People are lazy as hell, and they need people to just read for them.
And now
they
don't want to read themselves. A righteous woman will curse out another woman in her family if she's seen them doing something against the scripture. Like, you know the scriptures say you ain't supposed to be doing that.
That's right.
You're supposed to get on them.
That's your job.
Let them know.
To tell other women.
Yep.
Not men, tell other women. Let me read this
And book. Don't be scared to tell them either.
Revelation 1 and 3. Blessed is he that readeth.
Blessed is he that readeth.
Women. Isn't that in the scriptures? Did I just read that in the scriptures? Okay. Get your book and read it. Then it'll take the spirit to deal with you. If the spirit chooses to deal with you, it'll deal with you. The spirit.
That water.
You know, it'll get in your mind. You know, if you're sincere.
Because
most people, majority of most people, look for salvation, want to look for the Lord when they have a bad times. They don't look for the Lord when things is good. Am I right or wrong?
Right. I'm not having bad times.
Right. You just. Well, I understand. But that's what most people do, though. You know. But. Like I said, read your book, read the Bible. Because you're supposed to be reading it anyway. Because you're an Israelite. You don't have no business reading no Keeper Nigash or the Quran. Those unholy books. The Lord didn't give us those books to read. He gave us only the Bible to read. Only the Bible.
Yeah, I got a scripture for
it. King James.
That's
right.
What we got, King James.
King James.
Bible.
He was a black man. You should be able to identify. The reason why you read the Bible. Identify with it, and because this book is only for Israelites.
Yep.
That's the only reason why our people read the Bible.
Only an Israelite gonna be attracted to it and want to study it, want to read it.
Only.
And that's that spirit calling. You know what I mean?
Right. This is beautiful, man. This book. It's good. It's bad. You know.
I got a scripture.
And it has an answer for everything in this book. If you read it, you'll find how to deal with your problems and depressions, and you know.
What about the Lotus?
There you go.
Ain't no heathen gonna say that.
That's right. Only an Israelite gonna say that. Not the African Americans, but the Israelites.
Not no Egyptians.
Yeah.
That's a big thing too. They like to tell so-called black people they Egyptians.
Right. Look, let me show you this. What is that, the Deuteronomy? Difference?
Exodus 11 to 7.
You're right.
Sure. while you're getting that, I'm about to read this real quick. Isaiah 34 and 16. Seek ye out of the book of the Lord and read. No one of these shall fail, none shall want her mate. From my mouth it hath commanded, and his spirit it hath gathered
them.
That's
a commandment from the Lord. Seek ye out of the book and read.
And there's only one book, and that's this book. Like he said, it ain't the Quran, it ain't
the book of the dead.
Ain't no hieroglyphs. Mm, mm, mm. It's the Bible. That's it.
And that's all that matters that's in the hood. It got the hood all messed up.
Because they be putting that on TV. They get people watching the History Channel, getting interested in the Pharaohs.
In the middle of Persia.
You see that down there?
So they playing football? Oh, they really are.
Exodus 11 and 7. But against any of the children of Israel shall not a dog move his tongue, against man or beast, that ye may know how that the Lord doth put a difference between the Egyptians, those Hamites, and Israel. This is just for us. You see a Chinese person, a Japanese person, those nasty, creepy opians, the Ethiopians.
The Somalians.
This ain't for them.
Nope.
This ain't for them. We're some foul people. Watch it, if you got YouTube, access to YouTube. There's a movie, a documentary called Mongo Magic. If you get a chance, read it. Look at that. That's amazing, ain't it? Mongo Magic.
Oh, yeah, it's amazing, right? Just before, we gotta just warn people before they watch that one.
Yeah, you gotta warn them.
Damn.
Mine just exploded.
Oh man.
It's alright though.
She was headed. I knew where she was headed. Let's hold hands and let's pray. Right, that's what she wanted.
The prayer station is on Broad Street. You seen the prayer station?
Nah, dog.
It's on the bottom.
I'm going to go check it out.
No, it's really set up on the bottom. It's like, so when you go out west down West Broad, as soon as you cross the bridge,
kind
of getting close to Mount Carmel.
Okay.
There's a prayer station set up every day. A bunch of old ladies out there. They actually, it's like a look like a hot dog stand. It says the prayer station.
You know what? We need to go out there too.
We went up to that church.
Yeah, we need to go out there too.
But they had a pavilion set, a tent set up. They was having a revival.
Wow.
But nobody talked to us. If they did, they wouldn't want to. They wouldn't open the Bible up. They walk around with the Bible and it stay closed.
Right.
The prayer station. Yeah, we should go to the prayer station.
Hell yeah.
And we'll hit them with that Matthew. With that Matthew.
Praying in front of people.
Praying in the streets.
Yeah. That's a hypocrite's
day. They didn't say who.
That's
a gimmick.
Praying too.
Who? The prayer station? We gotta go talk to them.
They're probably praying to save.
Yeah. Man, I needed this water.
That's
man.
Some good water,
looked,
eh?
Looked out for real. For real.
He got this shit too. I didn't know Bushman's had good water.
Yeah.
This was filtered through the volcanic ashes or something.
What? Damn.
Norway.
Yeah. Russia. It has some Norwegian piss in it.
I think Russia thinks about hitting them. Yeah, I think Russia seriously considered hitting them.
Well, they had that submarine that was heading off the coast of Sweden.
Yeah. They said it was a Russian submarine in the water.
Yeah, because, you know, Norway and Sweden, they all sold out, man.
Sure did.
They were supposed to be the badass Viking countries. Where did all those your badass Vikings go? I think they actually left, though. I think they're over here. You know what I'm saying?
Right.
They're really, because there's nothing but a bunch of faggots over there in Norway.
It's so rude.
I know there's some Jakes over there, but most of them came over here. I bet you.
Oh, she'll come back here too.
Oh, hell no.
Oh, I can't talk to that.
Oh, she's coming back. Oh,
man, I can't do it, man.
God damn.
She got the Oki, the Oompa Loompa spirit. It's like, nah, that ain't
yeah,
right.
Because you look at a nigga, man. They do be having stupid ass.
Right there.
You see some of their lips be hanging sometimes, mouth be wide open. You know what I'm saying? That's the spirit of the
Oompa Loompa.
They be
on drugs and shit, too. Live prescription drugs and all that. She's safe.
Yeah.
I should be making fun of him.
That's fucked up.
about to say, you know she's an Israelite, she got great pop. Spago great.
That's that shit too.
They always making jokes about black people on the on you watch movies or something. What was that movie? When a dude can bust out with the great pop and he started pouring it out and the black just jumped out like, no, stop.
Was it a comedy?
It was some comedy, I can't remember. I don't watch movies no more. That's an old racist joke. Watermelons and grape pop and chicken.
I discovered I made a new potion smoothie, man, with watermelon.
Watermelon?
It's bad too.
I love watermelon, man. Or she went that way, now she going back there. Oh, she going to the bus stop. As we read Jeremiah, I'm going to get back to Jeremiah. Yeah, it's funny how the Spirit has had us in the book of Jeremiah heavy for the past 2 years. I've been noticing that about a lot of brothers' videos. Everybody reading always in Jeremiah. Because Jeremiah just getting on Israel the whole time.
Jeremiah had a heavy spirit on him.
Yeah.
Heavy spirit, man. I mean, just like Paul. Jeremiah, Paul.
Yeah.
Most of the brothers had heavy spirits on him. Yeah, man, you go through what Paul went through being blinded, man. You have a spirit on your ass, too. Especially if you imagine you knowing the truth, then the Lord blinds you and then give you your sight back after a couple of days, how powerful your spirit be then.
Especially have you seen him face to face.
Yeah. Oh, man.
The Lord speaking to you in Hebrew.
Oh, man.
Cursing you out in Hebrew.
Right.
It would do spiritual power.
Man, I got
God threw the spirit on him.
Real good, man.
Damn.
What
the fuck?
Oh shit.
You like her, don't you?
Hell nah.
Nah, I bet you plenty of Jake's wood.
Good, though.
Hey, she probably got some good food.
Oh man. That's awful.
You never knew. Probably only had scrap ones going up there.
Oh man, I just got a bad vision. I got,
What was I at, man? Jeremiah something. Because I wasn't finished reading it.
Was you in Jeremiah 4?
Like 5:21.
No, because you skipped to that part.
Yep.
It said, oh, ye foolish people.
Yep, sure did.
Laden with sins. Is that how it went?
5:6. Let me just go back to 5:6. I think it's 5.
Yeah, that's about
that's it.
Yeah, that's 5. Because it's hard because Jeremiah's like, it's just so much fire. Like, you can read anywhere. And he repeats himself a lot, too.
Oh, here we go. But this people, Jeremiah 5:23.
Yeah, but he was chugging a screwdriver and fucking mean mugging us. His motherfuckers have part before. I'm off, go ahead.
But this people have the revolting and a rebellious heart. They are revolted and gone. That's what we
Yeah, these people, they're revolting and gone. They are gone. They fucking gone. They're gone. Hey, and that just sounds good. You look at motherfucker, you just look at him like, oh, he's gone.
He's gone.
It's like your boy came up talking about that Islam shit, talking about, he said, oh, that King James, oh, that motherfucker.
Whatever. He was trying to talk shit, wasn't he?
Yeah.
But King James personally came and smacked him and his mama. That nigga just got a heart against, just want to get King James. Guy Fawkes,
you can't
the Guy Fawkes spirit,
Guy Fawkes spirit.
Yeah, almost.
That's
Guy
funny
Hamm.
How that's funny too. How the anonymous people, they on the internet, they behind all kind of protests. They wear the Guy Fawkes mask.
Yep, yep.
And Guy Fawkes was a fucking faggot. He tried to kill King James. He was hired by the Catholic Church to blow King James up in the Parliament during something they called a gunpowder plot. Get on Google, type in gunpowder plot. That's when the Catholic Church tried to assassinate King James. Obviously, they did not want this word coming out.
Obviously. For real.
You see, they killed William Tell. Let me go fast up. BT-1000. Bitch shaking up. Did you get that fat fucking thing on camera?
Neither say they in their heart, let us now fear the Lord our power that giveth rain, both the former and the latter in his season. He reserveth unto us the appointed weeks of the harvest. Your iniquities have turned away these things, and your sins have withholden good things from you. For among my people are found wicked men.
Yeah. Among our people are found wicked men. That's why people try to say, oh, you can't talk shit about Israelites. You can't call these women bitches and hoes, or call, you know, you say you can't talk bad about anybody.
Right, right.
You got a lot of people actually who know they're Israelites teaching the Bible, and they won't say no one's wicked or evil.
They're nobody, right, right.
They'll say only the white man's the devil.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
They lay wait as he that setteth snares, they set a trap, they catch men. As a cage is full of birds, so are their houses full of deceit. Therefore they are become great and waxing rich. They are waxing fat. They shine, yea, they overpass the deeds of the wicked. Hey, they catch men. They,
yeah,
well,
there
Timothy,
it goes. I'm sorry, let me catch you up.
Go ahead, bro.
No, I was just about to say, they overpass the deeds of the wicked.
Right.
They more wicked than Esau himself.
That's right.
What was you about to say?
That says trap, they catch men. Well, Timothy goes in how they catch silly ass women.
Oh, they catch the women?
You know?
Well, the woman's easy to trick. Yeah, the men's easy too.
Yeah.
Just so like how people got these bootlegged Israelite camps like IUIC and General Gehenna and all these other groups. It's easy for them to get these fools to sucker them in there, to get all their money, get them paying tithes. They getting all your checks.
Give them their earth, wind, and fire garment.
Yeah.
Shit, I got my own garment too.
Selling your merchandise out of you. They'll give, and to make you feel better about it, they'll give you a rank or a title.
Yeah, yeah.
You know, that makes up for it, right?
Yeah.
You're a
general Gahana.
You're a general, or you're a lieutenant. Or a captain. that makes up for you giving them all your money.
Oh, it's taking their garments to the cleaners. Getting that shit wine pressed and everything, bro.
Yeah, this shit ain't never been ironed. It's a spiritual garment. It stays clean. Just like when Moses and the Israelites were going through the desert, the whole time they was in the desert for 40 years, their garments never deteriorated. You know that? And their clothes never... Because archaeologists will say, well, we've never found any trace of clothes or anything.
You're looking.
In the desert. Well, why would you? The Bible specifically says that their garments did not wax old, they didn't deteriorate, they stayed in the Lord put like, it was like magic. Right. It was like magical clothes.
Right.
So y'all can understand. Their clothes did not, they just stayed in one piece.
Didn't mold,
didn't get old, didn't stink. Yeah, none of that. They just stayed in perfect condition for 40 years. Explain that.
Well, for this died. They died, they got buried in what they had. Burnt in the garments.
Hey.
It's a burn a lot, motherfucker.
That's the south side for you, bro.
Man, that's the worst sounding shit.
I ain't heard nobody listen to nothing good yet.
Yeah,
you don't hear no variety of music. The only one you heard listen to R&B was that hillbilly dude we said.
The truck, the pickup.
Yeah,
you heard them guys from Texas. Yeah.
Oh, was it? Okay.
Oh, okay, that's right.
That R&B affects my spirit too, though. All
that new R&B does.
Yeah,
that
old shit's way better.
That new R&B like rap music. Man.
Yeah, it sounds just like it is rap. They got rappers on every song.
Yep.
So they can't even do a whole song no more without someone coming through ruining it with a rant.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
It don't even go with the music either, but they gotta have that rapper come on there.
Gotta have
it. Tired of hearing that shit, man.
Just gotta have it. They are waxing fat, they shine, yea, they overpass the deeds of the wicked. They judge not the cause of the fatherless. That's what I like. They judge not the cause of the fatherless, yet they prosper. In the right of the needy do they not judge.
Hey, they don't give a damn about the needy.
They don't give a damn.
They're like fucking with your raggedy ass. Raggedy
ass. Hey, right. You ain't paying tights, nigga. Get out here.
Yeah, they make fun of us. They're like, y'all look like bums.
Yeah.
Well, maybe we are bums.
Yeah.
Maybe.
That's all right. We're supposed to be bums.
I guess the Lord was a bum.
Right.
He had, the Son of Man had nowhere to lay his, The foxes have their holes, like the birds have their nests, but the son of man don't have nowhere to lay his head.
That's right.
I guess he's a bum. I guess the son of man is a bum.
Shit. Shall I not visit for these things, said the Lord? Shall not my soul be avenged on such a nation as this? A wonderful and horrible thing is committed in the land.
Yeah, wonderful. It is. Right, this is wonderful and wickedness out here. They're wonderful. There goes the kid. Every car.
He can't even.
That shit
is so distorted. Y'all about to say that too.
You might as well just play some heavy metal with all that distortion. You know what I'm saying?
It sounds stupid.
Sound like his speakers is fucked up.
And Dave loved that shit.
Yeah,
too,
Dave would love it, boy.
Woo!
I remember one day I was cursing Dave out for listening to some Young Jeezy. He kept listening to it over and over. And he took the CD, he's like, I don't give a fuck about this shit. And then he smashed the CD.
Woo!
He probably did.
Woo!
Because you can't be in the troop listening to that shit.
It don't
It's
mix.
Not compatible.
I'm sorry.
You can't be in the truth listening to Lil Wayne and Jeezy. What? I don't even know what the new shit is. I got kind of hip like 5-6 years ago. I don't know where it's at now. I know how shit changes and there's some new shit out I don't know about.
Yeah.
It all sound the same.
It's always a local superstar coming up.
And that shit, the rap music ain't even progressed in the past 10 years. It's been stuck on retarded for like 10 years straight.
Yep.
No progression. It's been going backwards.
No evolution.
No progression.
Evolving. They can't evolve.
It's just degenerated into just pure fucking retardation.
Hey, y'all ever seen on YouTube them? It was like 6, 7, 8, 9 little nigga kids rapping about sucking dick.
Oh my God.
Ooh.
Yeah. Ooh. It was all rapping. Everybody had their own flow on it. A different flow on it too. Cause they went back to the, each one month and they had their own. They
were probably serious about something.
Yeah, they were serious. They were talking about blowing, sucking dick, swallowing, all that shit, man. I couldn't believe that shit, man.
It's just gone out here. Cause now, just think of the little children growing up now during the Obama administration. Cause ever since Obama came into office, they've been pushing that faggot shit harder and harder. Just think about the little children growing up. The only president they ever knew was Obama. You know what I'm saying? They was raised on LGBT rights.
When that was, when was he first elected?
In 2008.
So they old enough to know a lot more shit now.
Yeah.
Damn, that's, yeah.
Because they raising up and they raised up, this is the LGBT era.
Yeah.
Obama will be mostly remembered for faggot's rights. That's really what all he's got. On his resume, is he liberated?
Almost up.
It's almost up.
He's loved for that. He's loved. He's a beloved president.
Even though he deceitfully, when he first ran for office, what did he say? He said he believed marriage was between a man and a woman. But now he believes differently. So he is a liar. He's a hypocrite. You know, a politician would say anything to get elected. You know what I mean? Fuck all these politicians, man. They all a bunch of liars, a bunch of snakes. Anybody who put their faith in Obama is a fucking retard. He just a sheep. There was two old ass hillbillies bumping some fucking rats. That's all you see. Hey, nobody
this
listens
is
to
funny as fuck,
they don't
man.
Listen to country. They don't even listen to old school rock and roll,
man,
no
that
more.
Was nice, that was a nice system they had.
Hey, this sounds smooth, dude.
Yeah, it sounds nice.
But still, bro, what happened? What happened to the goddamn Waylon Jennings?
This is Parsons happening.
Yeah, Parsons, boy. Parsons is something else.
Oh my goodness, I don't know what to say, man, but goddamn, missile, please come.
Yeah, this shit gotta go.
Oh my Lord.
We have yet to see one white dude out here bumping some blood. Can't talk. They won't let me get a word in. This place is amazing though, man. So you should go out to the west side up in the bottoms.
They gone.
There be some bitches out there too.
They all be a prostitutes. I'm surprised there's not that many prostitutes out here. I bet they farther down that way.
Down by the fire station. We down there.
They be right here.
Like two or three of them.
Probably either right. Yeah, maybe we gotta go to a different spot on Parson. Yeah, down by the fire station, right in front of the clinic. Mm-hmm. That's where we gotta go in front
down
of the laundromat.
Down by Lincoln Park.
That's right by Lincoln. By Jenkins. It's right there on Jenkins.
I don't know the laundromat.
The laundromat's right in front of the, on the other side of the fire station.
Okay.
Yeah, I used to play video
games. That's where I is, so I'll roll down there.
Yeah, we should go down there next week or something.
Parson's ass.
Look at that hill in the truck. Mm. I think
mine was a country.
It's the first. Come on, buddy.
First man begging for a chance that he need to get back to Main Street. Now he's driving by in the car.
Really?
Yeah.
Main Street's, maybe he can't eat gas. He probably just lying.
Yeah,
he's like, Main Street's just right up here. You can walk.
This is sure Main Street too. This is shit on Main Street.
Main Street up at my house is crazy.
Man, I'm talking about by Ohio and Champion. Man.
Oh, that's up by your boy, Peraza.
Is that where he is? Yeah.
Oh, he's
down by
Detroit. He's right there by Ohio. He's farther down. that's raggedy as a motherfucker out there. This whole goddamn city is raggedy. There's nothing beautiful about this entire city. This entire country. This whole entire country is just I thought I was the bib. Yeah, this entire country is just a giant pile of shit.
Livingston.
It don't matter what street you go down, it gets worse. Just when you thought this shit was bad as it could get, it gets worse.
Surprised
me,
you
never
heard
that many
sirens today.
Oh, yeah. It'd be a slow day.
Yeah, it's picking up slow.
I'm picking up on the first.
Oh, what day of the month is it? Oh, yeah, them checks coming out tomorrow. Shit.
This is Jeremiah 7, and I'm going to start at, Behold, ye trust in lying words that cannot profit. Will you still murder and commit adultery and swear falsely?
Right, they trust in lying words. Oh, I just gave you an example from that great, wondrous leader of Barack Obama. He lied, like I said, he lied about the gay thing. He said he believed marriage was a man and a woman, but now he's saying anybody should have the right to get married. Those are lying words.
That's right.
Okay, keep going.
And burn incense unto Baal and walk after other gods whom you not know?
Oh, they burning incense to the devil. Right now, they about to have a satanic ceremony up in Detroit when they're going to unveil the Baphomet statue.
Oh, there he did it.
And they said in order to attend the ceremony, you must publicly announce that you sell your soul to Satan.
It's going to be a lot of people.
That's going to be a popular event.
Yeah, it's going to be a lot.
There's going to be a lot of people there.
I can't wait to see the whole damn video on it.
Oh, you know they will be all over YouTube and everything. They'll be proud of it.
And come and stand before me in this house, which is called by my name, and say, we are delivered to do all these abominations. Is this house, which is called by my name, become a den of robbers in your eyes?
Yes, all of our people are people that rob you.
This. I gotta remember this where I'm at too.
They will rob you, they'll kill you, they'll fuck your wife.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying? Rape your children. Like literally.
Literally.
They'll molest the hell out your children.
Behold, even I have seen it, said the Lord. But go ye now unto my place which was in Shiloh, where I have set my name at the first, and see what I did to it for the wickedness of my people Israel. And now, because ye have done all these works, said the Lord, and I spake unto you rising up early and speaking, but ye heard not, and I called you, but ye answered not. Therefore will I do unto this house, which is called by my name, wherein you trust, and unto this, the place which I gave you to you and to your fathers, as I have done to Shiloh, and I will cast you out of my sight, as I have cast out all your brethren, even the whole seed of Ephraim. Therefore pray not thou for this people.
Don't be praying for these wicked ass people.
Right.
Go ahead.
Neither lift up cry nor prayer for them, neither make intercessions to me, for I will not hear thee. Seeing thou not what they do in the cities of Judah and in the streets of Jerusalem, the children gather wood and father, and the fathers kindle the fire, and the women knead their dough to make cakes to the queen of heaven.
Hey, they do that every year on Christmas. They make those little cookies. Why are you leaving cookies out to Santa Claus? Because that's a tradition that goes back, because Christmas is actually Baal worshiping. And Baal's wife name is Asherah, which is also known as the Queen of Heaven. In Egypt, she was known as Isis, okay? She's called the Queen of Heaven, and you'll honor her by baking cakes for her. So that's why Santa Claus wears a little red hat, a little pointed hat. Because if you get on Wikipedia and look up a picture of Baal, you'll see he wears the same hat as Santa Claus. But Santa Claus is dressed in all red because that represents the devil. But Santa Claus is Baal, Mrs. Claus is the Queen of Heaven. The Christmas tree is Baal worship. It goes back to the serpent. Oh, like you got the Christmas tree represents the tree of knowledge of good and evil. And those little bulbs you put on the tree represent the forbidden fruit that the serpent gave to Eve.
Yeah.
And then you got presents under the tree. So symbolically it's saying that the devil gives you gifts. Satan, he gives you gifts. But go ahead. Yeah, they just drive crazy, don't they?
And to pour out drink offerings unto other gods that they may provoke me to anger.
Right, everybody drink that eggnog on Christmas, don't they? Got that drink offering?
Yeah, yeah.
They make all these offerings, have all these parties during Christmas. Christmas is straightforward Baal worship, devil worship. Straight up. Go ahead.
Do they provoke me to anger, said the Lord? Do they not provoke themselves to the confusion of their own faces? Therefore thus said the Lord, Lord Power, behold, my anger and my fury shall be poured out upon this place, upon man and upon beast, and upon the trees of the field, and upon the fruit of the ground, and it shall burn and shall not be quenched.
Yes, this is going to burn, man. The Lord's going to burn all these fools up, man, to a crisp. He's going to turn this place into a pile of ashes.
That's right. I'm going to read some more. Thus said the Lord of hosts, the power of Israel, put your burnt offerings unto your sacrifice and eat flesh. For I spake not unto your fathers, nor commanded them in the day that I brought them out of the land of Egypt concerning burnt offerings or sacrifices. But this thing commanded I them, saying, obey my voice, and I will be your power, and ye shall be my people, and walk ye in all the ways that I have commanded you, that it may be well unto you. But they hearken not.
They hearken not. They do not listen.
Nor incline their ear.
I like that word, hearken. You don't hear that word.
That's a bad word. That's a nice word to use. Yep. But walk in the counsels and in the imaginations of their evil hearts, and went backwards and not forward.
This place is backwards as hell. How many times have we said that?
Over and over.
They
over and over.
Backwards as hell.
Ain't this funny? We probably across the street from a wicked ass funeral home.
Yeah.
And that's supposed to be a preacher.
Get that funeral home on camera. Get the sign. Because really, this whole south side is a funeral home.
Yep,
it's a valley of dry bones.
Yeah, the walking dead.
The walking dead, the valley of dry bones.
Fucking zombies.
The actual walking, talking zombies.
Yep.
And they like, just like in a zombie movie, they trying to infect you with this virus. You know what I'm saying? You gotta stay away from them. If you get too close with them, you get infected.
That's right. Catch a virus. Since the day that they call it on Resident Evil, they call it the virus, don't they?
Yeah, the T-virus.
T-virus. All right, bro. What's up, man?
What's up?
Yeah.
Since the day that your fathers came forth out of the land of Egypt unto this day, I have even sent unto you all my servants and prophets, daily rising up early and sending them. Yet they hearken not unto me, nor incline their ear, but hearken their neck. They did worse than their fathers.
They're worse. Each generation out here gets worse and worse. People thought it was back in the 70s. They thought it was bad when the free love movement and the hippies broke out.
Oh, and man. They called them devils.
Yeah, they said they didn't have no idea how bad the women would get, mm-hmm. how degenerate shit would get out here. Mm-hmm. And like I said, now faggots can marry faggots. A woman can marry a woman. Legally. So this shit is just totally backwards, totally degenerate. This is the kingdom of Satan. And why that's why the Lord is going to destroy this country. It's a fire.
It's amazing.
Could you imagine if you told us old man back in the 50s, like, watch, boy, I'm telling you.
Yeah.
In the year 20, the year 2000, men are going to walk down the street with their pants around their ankles and you can see their butt cheeks. And that will be a common occurrence. They will not believe you.
Yeah, yeah. Man, you crazy.
Crazy.
Yeah, put that moonshine down.
I'm like, but yeah, you tell, yeah, faggots are gonna be able to marry a faggot. Nobody, that's unbelievable. You would never imagine that could actually happen.
Hell yeah.
But it's happened. And now homosexuals are a protected class. If you say anything bad about homosexuals, you get charged with hate speech, a hate crime.
That's where it's headed. That's where it's headed.
Yeah.
And they can make it a law that you can say faggot.
What?
I was about to say, that moon was looking beautiful.
It was a blood moon, not too long ago.
Yeah,
like about a week ago, a little bit over.
That one looks huge. Get that
it was
moon
an actual blood moon. Yeah. It was an actual
blue moon tomorrow night.
Oh, it's a blue moon? Every once in a blue moon, boy.
Yeah, that's tomorrow night.
I can't even see it.
Get it on camera?
Hold up.
I say, every once in a blue moon, boy, I drink me some whiskey.
Yeah.
Shit. You know that old saying, once in a blue moon. You're like, where the hell did that come from? The moon turns blue? Hey, so when's that next blood moon? The September? Is it 28th? Or?
It's definitely all fucked up, man, because it was a blood moon the other day, man.
There was. Yeah, I remember that blood moon. That was last month, wasn't it?
I know, it was like a couple weeks ago.
No, the last time the moon was full. So it had to be last month.
No, because it wasn't a full moon.
Oh,
it was a
okay.
It was a blood moon.
But there was a full blood moon like a month ago.
Right, last month. That was last month. So he ain't predict the shit that's happening.
No.
He ain't see it. It's everything he like seeing these products, seeing what's going on. He's like, oh shit. I ain't seen them, but bad omens coming, signs coming.
They think they can predict every heavenly occurrence.
Mm-hmm.
Too. Like,
the
blood moons only happen on this date and that date.
Right,
this date.
Right. Now shit is unpredictable.
The comet only comes through on this date. You don't know that.
Yeah.
They could. You know what I'm saying? The Most High pull a surprise eclipse on your
like
ass.
Like he's been doing.
Yeah.
When we first came to the truth, the very first Passover that I celebrated, I think that was 08. It was an eclipse?
I was still with my baby's mom, yeah.
Yeah, it was the eclipse, yep. On the Passover. It was an eclipse on the Passover.
I think she got mad because I put blood on the door.
Wow. Wow. Yeah, I remember that, man. That was amazing.
I remember that same year I came into the truth too. I think it was either same or right when I started getting into truth and stuff.
Right, right.
The same year, the moon, the Saturn was visible right beside the moon. It was big as fuck. You could see the rings and everything.
Damn.
That was the same year.
Same year?
Yeah.
Yeah, okay, it must have been some crazy shit.
That was a heavy year for the truth.
Right, right, right. Hell yeah, everybody was waking up.
Yeah, everybody started waking up.
Yep. Oh, it was a great awakening, 07, 08.